Today's modern-day astronomy heavily relies on telescopes. Because our planet's atmosphere causes light to distort before it reaches land-based telescopes, establishing observatories in space may provide us with better views of distant objects. This is why we have been so keenly focused on space telescopes. The Hubble telescope has been the most powerful telescope for humanity for decades and has taught us a lot about the universe, and is now being replaced by an even more powerful space observatory. The James Webb Space Telescope, which was launched in December of 2021, and has now finally reached its destination. The Hubble telescope has been our civilization's biggest accomplishment. Even though it has been operating for the last 31 years, Hubble has been able to only see about 10% of the galaxies out there and is limited in many ways. James Webb is capable of doing even more cooler things and looking at 13 billion years into the past to answer questions of our origins. But there are still many aspects that James Webb cannot answer. Another aspect and a very important question of our existence is whether we are alone in this universe or not. Is life rare? Is our planet the only one that harbors life? These are the questions only one telescope can answer, the Luvoir telescope, that is going to be even better than the James Webb and look for exoplanets that can find a second Earth. Hey there! Want to give your kids a boost in their science classes? Are you a homeschooler who want to engage kids with chemistry experiments? Choose Mel Science, as we are a leading ED tech company making science accessible and fun. Mel Science offers a range of topics like chemistry and STEM. Each month you'll receive a set with up to 3 awesome experiments. Their subscriptions are for ages 5 to 13 plus and include free VR and AR lessons on the Mel Science app. Mel Science is much more than a simple kids' experiment box. It's an educational platform. This app allows kids to actively engage in first-hand experience. If you have a busy schedule, don't worry. Mel Science app provides live lessons from professional PhD teachers. Let your kids engage with the science experts and ask intriguing questions on the live chat. If you'd like to get 60% off your first box, follow the link in the description or use the promo code CURIOSITY60 and get 60% off the first box of any Mel Science monthly or annual subscription. Mel Science app is designed by experts and approved by professionals and parents regarding safety issues. Subscribe to our channel and educate your children through fun. Despite the current enthusiasm surrounding the quest for faraway exoplanets, the 4,000-plus verified planets have remained unnoticed players on the cosmic stage. Except for a few extremely big things photographed by ground-based telescopes, almost all exoplanets have been discovered only when they momentarily shade the light from their host stars or cause the stars to wobble in a peculiar fashion. Scientists can calculate an exoplanet's orbit, radius, mass, and possibly density by seeing these patterns and utilizing a few other methods, but not much else. The planets are still, in the words of one field researcher, small dark shadows. Scientists are looking for much more. They want to discover the chemical makeup of the planet's atmospheres, if liquid water exists on their surfaces, and eventually whether these worlds are habitable. NASA faces a difficult choice now. Which telescope to select as the next big space telescope that will shape scientific research in the coming decades? Answering those questions will need the use of space telescopes that do not yet exist. NASA commissioned 2 major studies that took 4 years to complete and involved enormous teams of mainly volunteer scientists and engineers. The National Academy of Sciences is currently reviewing the findings as part of its decadal survey for astronomy and astrophysics, which will suggest government funding priorities through the 2030s. From the Hubble Space Telescope, which launched in 1990, to the James Webb Space Telescope, all NASA mega projects have gone through this similar screening procedure. The decadal survey is slated to complete its work and offer recommendations this spring. Among the 4 potential projects, NASA has to select one. This puts 4 ideas in the race for NASA's next great observatory in space. The Lynx X-ray Telescope, the Origins Space Telescope for investigating the early cosmos, and 2 telescopes devoted mostly but not entirely to exoplanets. One of them is called HABEX, which stands for Habitable Exoplanet Observatory. The 3rd proposal, Luvoir, stands for Large UV Optical IR Surveyor. It is the most ambitious, sophisticated, costly, and innovative of all. Luvoir is a telescope that, if built, would be capable of handling a wide range of scientific challenges. But its primary goal would be to provide scientists with the most accurate image yet of exoplanets that look to be like Earth on the surface, but no one knows what they are like on the inside. The decadal survey has resulted in some of the most important missions and advanced science like nothing else. If scientists truly want to know if life exists on faraway Earth-like planets, they'll need Luvoir or something very similar. But what exactly is Luvoir, and what are some of the features of this space telescope that make it stand out from its counterparts? Imagine the largest ground-based optical telescope we have today, like the Keck Observatory, and outfitting it with some of the best instruments that the current technology has to offer and send that telescope to space. That's Luvoir in a nutshell for you. The Luvoir concept study argues for a huge telescope mirror with a diameter of up to 15 meters, almost 50 feet. That's six times the size of the Hubble Space Telescope mirror and more than twice the size of the 6.5-meter Webb telescope. The most ambitious Luvoir would feature a mirror the size of a carnival Ferris wheel. According to the study report, the observatory's primary purpose is to accelerate the search for tiny, dim, Earth-like exoplanets circling sun-like stars in the hope that some of them could be habitable. No globe of that size and kind has ever been directly seen by a telescope, and doing so will necessitate the placement of a massive light-collecting bucket outside Earth's obscuring atmosphere. Direct imaging of such a weak object necessitates specific technological advances, most notably the use of a strong coronagraph, a screen that blocks off the planet's host star's dazzling light. To discover tiny, stony planets like our own, a sophisticated image camera inside the coronagraph equipment is required. Then an extremely sensitive spectrograph is required to identify components in a planet's atmosphere, like oxygen or methane, that may indicate the presence of life. The Luvoir study team concluded in its final report that the deluxe version of the observatory, as opposed to a scaled-down option that reduces the mirror size almost by half, could identify and study 54 potentially Earth-like planets, as well as hundreds of larger planets over a five-year observing period. The figure is calculated by comparing the telescope's technical parameters to the number of tiny, rocky exoplanets projected to exist in our cosmic neighborhood based on data from NASA's Kepler survey mission over the previous decade. The inbuilt coronagraph and the massive size of the telescope itself, which has 40 times the light-gathering power of Hubble and can record photos far faster, will be critical to accomplishing the 54-planet objective. In one important manner, Luvoir is reminiscent of Hubble. Webb and the multifunctional Nancy Grace Roman Space Telescope, both planned for the 2020s by NASA, will observe predominantly in the infrared. Luvoir, like Hubble, will be sensitive throughout a wider range of wavelengths, from ultraviolet and visible light to the near-infrared. This enables it to observe the spectral fingerprints of a diverse range of chemicals, which may indicate biological processes and an action on a faraway globe. Astronomers hope that this multi-purpose telescope will be able to achieve a variety of astronomical research aims, such as studying Jupiter's cloud tops with a 15-mile or 25-kilometer resolution, and hunting for biosignatures in the atmospheres of other planets. According to the study report, the observatory's major purpose is to speed up the search for small, faint, Earth-like exoplanets circling sun-like stars in the hopes of locating ones that may potentially support life. Another objective is to make astrophysics research more accessible, including topics such as the reionization period, galaxy creation and development, and star and planet formation. It would also be capable of doing high-resolution imaging and spectroscopic examinations of solar system planets, with one of its key scientific goals being to identify and characterize Earth-like planets circling adjacent stars. Luvoir would provide answers to the most pressing questions we have about our universe, from things in our solar system to exoplanets, stars, galaxies, and the most massive cosmic structures of all. If Luvoir would have been proposed a decade ago, it would have been a fishing expedition. Today, after the launch of James Webb, scientists are confident it will produce solid results. What's exciting is that the questions of our origins and search for life outside Earth are slowly gaining more pace and popularity. We have important suggestions to the decadal survey in the context of knowing for certain that there are Earth-sized planets in our reasonably close neighborhood that get Earth-type energy from their suns. This is the first generation of conceptions to include that knowledge and make it a fundamental component of their scientific case. The other exoplanet observatory under consideration for future financing, HabX, would likewise be able to image tiny Earth-like planets directly. However, its 4-meter mirror would pick up on considerably fewer of them. In comparison to the 54 exoplanets predicted by Luvoir, HabX is projected to locate 8 during the next 5 years. In terms of spatial resolution, the capacity to perceive details, Luvoir can provide pictures that are 6 times sharper than Hubble and 4 times sharper than HabX. As a result, it may be able to offer photographs similar to the iconic pale blue dot image of Earth acquired by Voyager 1 in 1990 from a distance of 3.7 billion miles, but for planets 100,000 times further away. In these photographs, the planets will span only a few pixels, which may not seem like much. However, the hue of those few precious pixels holds a remarkable amount of information. The extreme coronagraph for living planetary systems, ECLIPSE, would allow scientists to read the contents of planetary atmospheres like never before, detecting molecules such as oxygen, ozone, water vapor, carbon dioxide, and methane that might represent biosignatures. Because neither Hubble nor JWST can detect Earth-like planets around sun-like stars, Luvoir marks a significant advancement in astrobiology. Exoplanets would be seen as members of distant solar systems rather than solitary worlds by the telescope. We would be able to calculate the atmospheric compositions of numerous planets in a solar system, given their orbits, masses, and temperatures, and to do so for planets orbiting a variety of suns. Although exoplanet science would be the observatory's primary goal, its massive mirror and wide range of wavelengths might be utilized to examine everything from distant galaxies to things in our own solar system. Luvoir, for example, would view Jupiter in roughly the same detail as cameras on the Juno probe, which is presently in orbit around the planet. The goal of Luvoir is to build an observatory that can narrate the narrative of the cosmos from its inception through the ubiquitous presence or absence of life. So we prefer to suggest that Luvoir is a concept or an idea rather than a set of numbers that will be created. If these initiatives are successful, they will provide Luvoir with a technological advantage. However, given its goals, the observatory will be costly, with lifetime costs estimated to range between $18 billion and $24 billion for the proposed 15.1-meter Luvoir A variant. To prevent price shock, the Luvoir team has developed backup plans for an 8-meter version named Luvoir B, which would cost $12 billion to $18 billion. Either version of Luvoir will cost NASA a lot of money, but team members say it's equivalent to what the Hubble Space Telescope spent throughout its lifespan. The capability difference between the 15.1-meter Luvoir A and the 8-meter Luvoir B generally corresponds to their size difference. Luvoir A could discover 54 habitable planet prospects. However, Luvoir B can only find 28. For the time being, if approved, Luvoir A is the largest space telescope we can create. Its 15.1-meter mirror is the largest that can fit into the next generation of heavy-lift rockets, including NASA's Space Launch System and SpaceX's Starship. The observatory, folded up within the rocket during launch, would be launched into cold, dark space, away from Earth's warmth and brightness, to a gravitationally stable location known as Lagrange Point 2. No matter which variant of Luvoir is chosen by NASA, one thing is sure, that it is the next big space telescope that will shape the scientific research of the coming decades. So what do you think about this insane next big space telescope? How will it shape up the future of space telescopes and astronomy? Let us know what you think in the comment section below. Also, make sure to like our video and subscribe to the channel, as it encourages us to keep making amazing videos like this for you. Thanks.